What's up guys, my name is Selim Shaimi, and in this video I will explain to you the differences between artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning. I just want to emphasize that these topics have been studied by experts for a decade, and the goal here is to give you an intuitive understanding of it. So for a long time we were trying to replicate our thought by giving a lot of rules to computers, and we thought that as a result we would build an artificial intelligence. It turned out to be a terrible way. Instead, researchers began to write algorithms that learn from themselves, and it was the beginning of machine learning. So to answer the question, what is machine learning, I would say that machine learning is a subfield of artificial intelligence where machines can learn from data without explicitly programmed instructions, without rules. For instance, let's suppose that we have to build an algorithm that can play tic-tac-toe. You have two cases. In the AI case, you would have to take it by its hand and give it many logical rules to learn how to play. As a result, you cannot build a machine that is good at tic-tac-toe without being good at it yourself. In the machine learning case, you may not know how to play tic-tac-toe yourself, yet you can still come up with a great software. Unlike the AI case, you give it many examples of previous games and let it learn the rules by itself. So today, machine learning is showing the most promise at providing tools that the industry and society can use. Deep learning is a subfield of machine learning. You can consider it at the cutting edge of the cutting edge. Like in machine learning, the data is fed through neural networks, which are algorithms that take inspiration from the human brain, and those neural networks will extract a numerical value called output for every data. So it can be images, it can be voices, it can be text, and then it will classify this data. For example, it can tell you if a given image is a cat picture or not. Okay, so now let's take an example and let's suppose that we want to build an animal classifier that tells you if a given picture is a cat or a dog. In the machine learning case, we would have to define features such as if the animal has ears and if yes, then if they are pointed. We would have to define all the facial features and let the system learn which features are the most important to classify a specific animal. But deep learning takes a step ahead and automatically finds out the features which are important for classification. We don't have to do anything. Now I want to explain to you why deep learning only takes off recently, and there are many reasons to that. So first off, deep learning requires a large amount of data which have been possible due to the recent digitalization of our society, because everybody is now using a smartphone that produces data. Secondly, deep learning requires a lot of computational power which has only been available recently. As you can imagine, requiring a large amount of data is a drawback, because it's hard to gather. Having substantial computational power is costly. Consequently, deep learning is expensive. So is deep learning the way to go? Of course nobody knows, but deep learning pioneer Geoffrey Hinton says we need to start from the beginning. We need to start over. Thank you so much for watching guys, I just want to add that I'm doing these videos because I believe that AI is about to transform society, and I think it's very important for people to understand the basics of it. My belief is that this channel will inspire students in the future and perhaps get them interested in this fascinating topic, so I hope it will help.